Welcome to the great Exodus series, God's plan of rescue for his children, Let My People Go, the path to mountain. My name is Michael, I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today our topic is Mount Zion, Psalm 48, our bulwark and our stronghold. Mount Zion is the stronghold of the Lord, his special place. To have a look at it, let us go to Psalm 48. Zion, the city of our God, Psalm 48. Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised in the city of our God, in the mountain of his holiness. Beautiful for situation, the joy of the whole earth is Mount Zion, on the sides of the north, the city of the great king. God is known in her palaces for a refuge. For lo, the kings were assembled, they passed by together. They saw it, and so they marveled. They were troubled and hasted away. Fear took hold upon them, and pain as of a woman in travail. You breakest the ships of Tarshish with an east wind. As we have heard, so be seen in the city of the Lord of hosts, in the city of our God. God will establish it forever, Selah. We have thought of your loving kindness, O God, in the midst of your temple. According to your name, O God, so is your praise unto the ends of the earth. Your right hand is full of righteousness. Let Mount Zion rejoice, let the daughters of Judah be glad, because of your judgments. Walk about Zion and go round about her. Tell the towers thereof. Mark you well her bulwarks. Consider her palaces, that you may tell it to the generation following. For this God is our God for ever and ever. He will be our guide even unto death. Now, if you see here, in Psalm 48:4, that the kings were assembled, they passed by Mount Zion, they saw Mount Zion, and they were afraid, and they ran away, and they started to hide. That reminds us to Revelation 6, at the sixth seal, when all the people will see Mount Zion coming down, and they will hide in the caves because they're afraid. As you can see also here later, it is about the judgment that will fall in Psalm 48:11, because judgment will fall of God. The wrath of the Lamb has come with Mount Zion. And a little bit down in Psalm 48:13, you see, mark you well her bulwarks, the strongholds of Zion. Consider her palaces, the places prepared for the people that will be raptured into paradise, that you may tell it to the generation following. That is a reference to the 144,000 that will see the glory of Mount Zion, and they will be trained there. And then they will go into the trumpet tribulation period and will tell about it to the generation following. We see in the Psalm 48, we see a clear statement about Mount Zion that it will come down. And it will come down at the sixth seal. And we will be standing there at the base of Mount Zion, as the foundation of Mount Zion, as a multitude closed and wide, and there we will be raptured into paradise. And we will enter into the palaces of Mount Zion. We live there forever and ever. But the 144,000, they will see all the glory of Mount Zion and paradise and everything. They will be trained, but they will return back to the earth during the trumpet period and will help to bring the Jews back to the Lord. They will accept Jesus Christ finally. But what we are teaching about Mount Zion is in so many times written in the Bible. It's Isaiah 4, it's Psalm 48, the harvest worker described in Luke 10, Micah talks about Mount Zion, and many, many other places. So please walk with us together, walk with us that path to Mount Zion, because there is our rapture, there is the rapture of the church. We will walk with you. We will build the dwelling places of Zion, as is written in Isaiah 4. And we will bring as many people as possible to righteousness, as is described in Daniel 12:3. So let us gather the harvest into the barn, and bring together the multitude clothed in white. Join us, become an elder, a state or national leader of triple grace. Sow into the ministry, help us to bring the message forth, and gather the people together into the assemblies of the dwelling places of Zion. Read about it, Isaiah 4, Psalm 48, Micah, Luke 10, about the people that he will send out filled with the Holy Spirit, that they can do miracles. These will be the harvest workers, the first fruit of the rapture that will go forth to bring in the wheat into the barn of the Lord. And you can be part of it. Join us. Establish a dwelling place of Zion, a society of the rose in your neighborhood. This is our purpose, to gather the people together with the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, under the new tabernacle that will be there as a refuge for all his children. Thank you that you have listened to this topic. And tomorrow we follow up with another one about Mount Zion and the great harvest coming. Thank you that you have listened. Have a blessed day, and I will see you again tomorrow. Maranatha.